Hey everybody, this is Brajesh here and you are watching CAB Infoventory. In my earlier video, I shared with you legal and important point for dismissal of check bounce case against you by the court, that is legal liability with the help of various examples for your easy understanding. Now I am going to share with you this further in detail with some more examples so that you can understand this properly and apply to your check bounce case in defense and win the case. Keep watching this video till end in order to get the full benefit out of this. Now I will discuss another example. This will look you rather more interesting. Now, as I told you that there should be a legal liability, my dear friends, there should not only be a legal liability, but it should be existing one also. Yes, it should be existing one. Now you will ask that what is this existing liability? This is also very important and very crucial for a case to be defended by you. There should not be any future legal liability upon you. For example, you have taken a loan of rupees 10 lakh, that is car loan, from your bank for 5 years and you are paying EMI, that is equated monthly installment of rupees 20,000 every month to your bank. After paying installment for 5 months, 6th installment got bounced due to non-payment by you. Then your bank files a case for recovery of that bounced ECS under section 138 of the Negotiable Instrument Act against you for recovery of that amount. You may recall that your bank had already taken post-dated blank signed check from you, that is PDC, at the time of the disbursement of loan. Now, what your banker does, he fills the entire outstanding amount of rupees 9 lakh plus up to date outstanding interest plus penalty in the blank check after payment of 5 EMIs by you, say for rupees 10.5 lakh in the PDC given by you to your banker and present it to your bank for payment. Naturally, the check gets bounced due to insufficiency of funds. Please note that your lender has not recalled this loan and has not issued any loan recall letter to you for this loan, stating therein that your EMI has bounced and therefore it is recalling the entire loan today from you before presenting this PDC to your banker for payment. Hence, though your banker has got this check of rupees 10.5 lakh, that is for principal, interest and penalty bounced, but this entire amount was not your existing liability. No doubt that you are liable to pay rupees 10.5 lakh to the bank as on date, but whether this entire amount of rupees 10.5 lakh was your existing liability or not is to be looked into and checked from the facts of your case. My dear friends, this total amount of 10.5 lakh was not your existing liability on the date when the check got bounced. On that date, only existing liability, that is one EMI of rupees 20,000, was payable by you and not the entire amount of rupees 10.5 lakh, because you have taken the loan for 5 years from the bank and the remaining amount except one EMI was your future liability. This is the finer and minute difference between a future liability and existing legal liability. Only 1 month EMI was your existing liability and not the entire amount of rupees 10.5 lakh. Please note that you have taken the loan for 5 years of rupees 10 lakh and that is to be repaid in 60 monthly installments and not within 1 year, and you will be repaying rupees 20,000 each month in the form of EMI. Therefore, when after 5 months, when the bank presented the check for rupees 10.5 lakh and got the check bounced and did not recall that loan before that, then your existing liability was not rupees 10.5 lakh. That was a future liability, and your existing liability was rupees 20,000 only. Hence, in this case, since rupees 10.5 lakh was not your existing liability, but a future legal liability, and your existing liability was only rupees 20,000. So in this case, when there was no existing liability, but future liability, and check was presented for future liability, then these facts will also go in your favor, because there was no existing legal liability upon you. Now I will share with you another example for your easy understanding. Say for example, you want to purchase stolen goods or smuggled goods, that is chori ka maal, from somebody, and you have issued check for the purchase of those stolen goods or smuggled goods, or you have purchased certain goods from a person which are prohibited by law or is illegal, or you want to purchase certain goods which are banned under the Narcotics and Drug Protection Act, and you issued a check for those purchases and check got bounced, and that person made a court case against you for the recovery of that amount for bounced check. Now question will be coming to your mind that whether check which you have given to that person shall be treated as your legal liability or not. Answer is big no, not at all. It shall not be treated your legal liability, because the contact between you and that person was for an unlawful and illegal activity, and therefore this contract shall not be recognized as a valid contract in the eye of law as per Contract Act. Purchase of stolen goods is unlawful. Also, purchase of banned narcotic drugs is illegal. Hence, if the contract itself is unlawful and is not legal and is invalid, then whatever consideration you have paid for that unlawful activity or illegal contract, how that can become lawful or legal? Therefore, in this case also, there is no legal and enforceable liability upon you, and you will be acquitted in this case. Let me discuss with you another example also. Say for instance, you are running a company and you are a director of that private limited company. Your company issued a check to somebody and that check got bounced, or your company gave a check to some of its dealer or supplier or customer or to somebody for that matter, which gets bounced, and that person files a suit against you for recovery of that amount for the bounced check. Here that person to whom check was issued by the company has filed a suit against you in your personal capacity as well as against the company. Please note that as per section 141 of the Negotiable Instrument Act, if a check issued by the company is bounced, then the company will be liable, and every person who was controlling and running the business of that company, or who was in charge of the business of that company and the business was run under his guidance and supervision, shall also be treated as an accused and shall be liable for the check dishonor. That person can be any person, and designation of that person does not matter, whatever may be his designation in that company. This is called vicarious liability. The meaning of vicarious liability is to become liable for somebody else's act. Here, if you are working in a company, whether you are an accountant or a director or a manager, whether you are a director or a general manager, and a check of your company bounced, and the party to whom this check is issued has filed a case against the company and has made you also an accused in your personal capacity. Now, to get acquitted from this case, you have to prove before the court and you should be able to explain such circumstances with documentary evidence or otherwise that at the time when the offense happened, that is, when the check got bounced, then at that time you were not in charge of the business of that company and you were not conducting the business of that company. The business of the company was not conducted under your supervision. You were not in charge of that business and it was not within your knowledge that this check had been issued to the other party. Further, this was also not in your knowledge that if that check would have been issued, then it will get bounced. Hence, if you are able to satisfy the court about the various facts with documentary evidence which I discussed with you just now, then also you will be acquitted. However, the company remains an accused and the other employees or officers of the company who were actually in charge for conducting the business of the company will also be liable, but you will be acquitted if you are able to prove before the court with the documentary evidence that you were not in charge of the business when the bounce check was issued. So, you will be acquitted if you are able to prove before the court that you did not know about this and you were not having any responsibility as in charge in that company, nor there are your signature on the check. Also, you were not authorized signatory of the company when the bounce check was issued, and neither you knew that how much is the balance in the bank account of the company, and you are not at all related in any manner whatsoever to this check bouncing, even if you were the employee of that company. Then you will win this case in your personal capacity and you will be acquitted from this case. Now take another example. You should check in the facts of your case that whether the check which got dishonored was presented within the validity period of 3 months from the date of its issue by the other party or not. If the check was presented by the party after 3 months period from the date of its issue and check got dishonored due to this reason, then you will be acquitted from the check dishonor case. Further, you should note that if you are acquitted from the check bounce case under the Negotiable Instrument Act, then it does not mean that the other party cannot file a civil recovery suit against you. Say for example, on any technical ground, that is, maybe on limitation period, you get the case dismissed under Section 138 of the Negotiable Instrument Act, still you are liable to pay the amount, or if the bank has presented the check by filling increased amount and the case of bank got dismissed on that ground. Even then, you were not liable for that increased amount of the check. However, you were liable to pay that reduced actual amount and bank will file the civil recovery suit against you. So, the civil recovery suit is a civil suit which will run parallelly and separately against you for the recovery of that amount. Likewise, though the police does not file FIR in the cases under Section 138 of the Negotiable Instrument Act, but if the facts of the case show to the police that you have done forgery with other person or you have done cheating or aapne kisi ka maal hadap liya hai, after issuing the check you have absconded or your malafide intention is apparent from the facts of the case that you have done all these things with the intention to defraud the other person, then the FIR may be filed against you under the relevant sections of the Indian Penal Code, that is under section 420 as per the facts of the case. My dear friends, though dishonor of check is in itself not an offense as per section 138 of the Negotiable Instrument Act, and it is an offense if there is a legal liability. Once you are proved guilty by the court, then you can be punished with imprisonment up to 2 years, and you may be liable to pay the double of the amount of the check bounced as fine may be imposed upon you also, or both. Hope this video would help you out in getting acquittal from the court in check bounce case and win the same. Stay safe and healthy. Bye-bye.